on behalf of Tissot. I'm sure you're very excited to be here today. Let me just tell you a little bit about luxury brand Tissot. They are the official timekeepers for so many sporting events, which is why they are so excited about the fact that they have so many sporting partnerships. Let me tell you, as all of you well know, as a sports presenter, it's okay, now you can get your round of applause out that you wanted to get for Virat. Well, that looks very stylish, and ladies and gentlemen, all three of us in fact are Virat later as well to capture the noodles we watch. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much, Sumanthur. Have a seat. I know it's been a busy day for you. Just a normal day in the house, huh?
Yeah, that's a normal day.
So first and foremost, Virat, excited to have you here. Whenever we say you have off time for cricket, there's actually no off time for you.
Chrono XL, which I really like. This is the latest addition to the Tissot collection and something which I really enjoy because of the size and how the watch looks. It's very clean as well, so something that I enjoy a lot, and very happy to have it. Plus, yeah, it's just nice to be resting for a bit, you know, relaxing. Very important to have these times as well, and I'm just embracing it, enjoying all the downtime, trying to recoup and recover, and on the road again soon.
I know we're all looking forward to that, and I often say that a brand like Tissot has prided themselves with the fact that they have gone ahead and they are, you know, associated with a lot of sporting fighting rights, a lot of sporting international events, but they're also associated with this collaboration with Virat Kohli, a partnership I like to call it, that has gone on for more than 3 years now. What has that journey been like for you?
Well, the journey obviously has been really nice. I mean, it came along at the time where, you know, I was just getting into the peak of my career. It was just at the start of 2016, and you know, 2.5 years into it, it's been a wonderful association. The thing that stood out for me with Tissot was the legacy that it carries with it, and you know, the trust that the brand has been able to maintain with people out there, and that's something that, you know, I believe in as well. Excelling at what I do, being honest to my work, and just giving everything that I have towards making something work, and that's something that Tissot believes in too. And the match was perfect, and yeah, it's been a great association so far.
And you know what, as girls we're lucky, we have so many accessories. I mean, my watch is from the Cheminda Tourelle range, but Virat's is the new range. It is a main accessory. Man, you're so stylish. I mean, look at that. You know, you're pretty stylish off the field as well. So, since you've seen a lot of Tissot watches, which one do you really like the most? You know, what kind of watch suits you the best, you feel?
Well, the Cheminda obviously is a classical watch. That was the first watch the first one I got from Tissot. But my current favorite is the Powermatic, which is a very, very classic watch. It's quite sleek, very light, and the dial is very simple. Plus the chronos as well. I mean, I carry a chrono with me to the game. I wear it to the game. I wear it in presentations as well. So, yeah, but on a daily basis, I wear the Powermatic, which is quite a elegant looking watch.
It also reflects so much about, you know, a person's, like, a personality, your attitude. It's so important the way that you pick out a watch. So, you know, for all the fans here, for the men, the girls, the boys, any tips on how to get the perfect watch?
Well, depends from person to person. You know, some people like big chunky watches, some people like elegant looking classy watches, some people like the dial to be heavy and, you know, feel the weight on the wrist. Some people like it light, so it's just a personal preference. But the one thing that I am very specific about in my watches is that the dial should be classic. It should not be too loud or too busy. you know, the metal it's made of, whether it's gold or steel or whatever, should speak for itself. But the dial should be nice and relaxed, and you know, it should not be confusing. To be very honest, so yeah, that is something that I always look for in my watches. And look, the classical watches, you know, run through time, and they'll never go out of fashion. So that's something that I believe in.
That's right. Innovators by tradition for a reason. So if you had to give someone a Tissot watch, who's it going to be, and which watch would you give them?
Well, it depends.
Again, let's pick someone. Pick anyone. Doesn't even have to be your teammate.
I would give Chahal a watch because he's always late. So I'll give him any watch just to keep a check on
time.
It's
going to be a little tricky to find a watch that doesn't fall off his wrist. Let's be a little honest about that.
I know, it'll have to be a rubber band strap or something, because all the other straps will be loose for him.
Fair enough. Now we're going to have some fun, really, aren't we? Because as Virat just mentioned, he's got a little bit of downtime, which is why he can be here with all of you. But of course, you've got this. Before we move on to IPL, I just got to say, just going back to what happened in South Africa, so many personal milestones for you as well. You know, you carry that form forward, you're scoring centuries, nothing new, picking up the test mace yet again, and now back into the cricket. Looking forward to the IPL, physically fit, mentally ready?
Yeah, physically I had a few niggles. I'm just getting over those niggles. You know, it's the workload has started to disagree with me a little bit. So I have to be very careful about how I go forward with my body, my mind, and my cricket. So, you know, times like these are very, very important going ahead. And I'm totally enjoying it. You know, I don't even have an inch of me missing out on anything, because my body really needed this. Although I'm keeping a track on the games, I watch the boys play, you know, whenever the matches are on. And yesterday, again, it was a really good win for us. But look, I don't watch matches right now and feel like I want to be on the field, because I've started to listen to my body. And yeah, when I'm done with this period, obviously IPL, I'll be coming out fresh. I'll be mentally in a better place to want to be out there on the field, because I've been on the road for a long time. You know, I've hardly missed any games. And yeah, look, you need to pay respect to your body as well at times. And as I said, this phase is very important for me.
So let's take your mind further away from cricket. We have fun, a little bit of a rapid fire for you. Some of your fans might actually already know the answers, or think they know the answers. So surprise us, Virat. Favorite holiday destination?
Favorite holiday destination would be somewhere in Europe.
Nobody owes you?
Yeah, somewhere in Europe. Yeah. But if I'm playing cricket and I want to have some downtime, I think Australia is a great place. But if I want to be on a holiday where no one recognizes us, then definitely somewhere in Europe or one of the Arctic countries, you know, where there's so much snow that
people...
Have
you been?
Yeah, I have. Yeah, I have been. And it's a wonderful experience. No one knows you at all. And just to be able to walk on the streets going unnoticed is a great feeling.
You, like I introduced you as someone who's kind of transformed India's sporting culture, is mainly because of what you eat. So what's your favorite cuisine?
Now, Japanese. Earlier it was...
For a couple of years, I think, though, you like the Japanese, because it's most healthy, isn't it?
Yeah. For about 3 years now, I can eat Japanese food at any time of the day. I totally love the cuisine. I've developed a taste for it, but earlier it was Mughlai, butter chicken and all that. But I'm far from it now.
I tell you what, if rumors are to be believed, Virat Kohli has not touched carbs in 6 years, if rumors are to be
believed. That's
why I want to ask you that is because for us, that's like comfort food, like cheat day food. So do you have comfort food? Do you have a cheat day? Do you give yourself that time?
Cheat day for me would be some gluten-free...
No, it has to have gluten, Virat. Come on. It's not a cheat day without something fried and without something gluten.
That's what I'm saying. You know, it's not only black or white. It's a mixture of everything. You have to understand that you can't live without carbs. You know, as a human being, you have to eat carbs. But what kind of carbs you eat is what is important. And that's what I keep a check on. So when I have people come and tell me, oh, you haven't eaten carbs in 6 years, and I tell them, you got to be joking, man. I would be on the hospital bed, you know. So I'm very smart about what I eat, and that's been the main factor for me. So indulging in, I would probably have a gluten-free dessert, which is you know, made of natural sugar and all that stuff. So that once in a while I do, but I don't get those cravings anymore.
And that's what I was going to ask. Do you have a craving?
global advertiser for innovative outdoor solutions.
Global as a company, it has never compromised on its service quality and commitment. And that is the reason our clients do keep on coming again and again to us for our service. The mission of the company is to rise on the graph of betterment for every campaign handled by us.
Sir, आपकी फिल्म द ग्रेट लीडर आ रही है, इस पर कुछ रोशनी डालिए।
रोशनी लीडर के साथ अपने आप चलती है और हम क्या रोशनी डालेंगे उसके ऊपर। एक बहुत ही अच्छा विषय है इस फिल्म का, महिलाओं के प्रति जो है समाज में आजकल और कई गांवों में कई क्षेत्रों में अत्याचार होता है, उनको बढ़ावा नहीं दिया जाता, इसी के दायरे में ये कहानी बनी गई है। हीरो के पिता की भूमिका हम निभा रहे हैं और हमारी पत्नी जया जो है वो हमारी पत्नी का रोल कर रहे हैं। तो ये एक हिंदी वर्जन है, तो मुझे बड़ा गर्व है कि मैं इस फिल्म में काम कर रहा हूँ।
द ग्रेट लीडर फिल्म के निर्माता दीपक सावंत हैं, जो पिछले 45 वर्षों से आपके मेकअप आर्टिस्ट हैं। लोग जानना चाहते हैं कि शूटिंग पर दीपक सावंत आपकी नज़र में मेकअप आर्टिस्ट होते हैं या निर्माता?
ये मेकअप आर्टिस्ट पहले मेकअप हमारा करते हैं, उसके बाद ये निर्देशक बन जाते हैं।
इस फिल्म की सफलता के लिए आप दर्शकों से क्या कहना चाहेंगे?
ग्रेट लीडर जो है वो जा करके देखें और मैं उम्मीद करता हूँ कि आपको पसंद आएगी और आपको सराहनीय लगेगी।
दीपक जी की फिल्म के लिए ग्लोबल एडवर्टाइजर्स ने बहुत सपोर्ट किया है, इस पर आप क्या कहना चाहेंगे?
हाँ, जिन लोगों ने इनको सपोर्ट किया है उनको हम धन्यवाद देते हैं और इसी तरह उनको सहायता बनी रहे ताकि ऐसी फिल्मों का प्रचार हो, और उनको हमारी तरफ से बहुत बहुत शुभकामनाएं और अभिनंदन और स्नेह और आदर।
ग्लोबल एडवर्टाइजर फॉर इनोवेटिव आउटडोर सॉल्यूशंस।